Hi, my name is Yvan Dutil. This is Sonar Calling GJ273b.
In 1999, I've been involved in a project called Encounter 2001 at that time, and what became the first cosmic call. This message has been sent in 1999, and another version, more compact, has been sent in 2003. And this message, actually, the 2003 message, is the basis of the message I've designed for the Sonar transmission. We designed this message like we designed in the past with my colleague Stéphane Dumas. So some people call it the Dumas Dutil method. Actually, it's quite simple. We start by teaching them basic math, how to count, how to add, how to divide. And then we go to physics. And then we finish the message with short description of us, a picture of human. And then we finish the message with a question. So please call back. The way it works is like fax machine, for those old enough to remember that. What we do, we're sending a line, black and white. And then we have some marker at the end of the line. And then just fold it line by line. That says how you make your picture. And there is this square box around it that you know that you must align it properly. The first two messages I designed was very long string, like a very long band. And then I didn't like this idea. I said I thought about that for the last 15 years. So if you lose, for some reason, the first 2 minutes of transmission, you lose the explanation how to read the second part. So if you lose the beginning, you lose everything. So what I did for the Sonar project, I just fold the message. And now instead of a very long rectangle, we have a square. So I fold it in this four column. So if I have some reason, we lose part of it. We don't lose all the beginning. We have a special character set that has been designed really noise resistance. They are ugly. They're very ugly, but the advantage resembles no human language. So there is this neutral representation of humanity. We have one picture, which is a man and woman, which is based on the Pioneer plague, which was on the Voyager space probe also, with a slight modification. We changed the position of the arm of the woman, because in the original message, she has a two arm in the same position, and some people thought, if you're not a human, you may not understand that she can fold her arms. One of the elements I put in the message is the largest prime number we have found. And we have done it by brute force mathematics, which is literally thousands of computers cracking down number, trying to find those extremely rare and extremely big prime number. So maybe we are in a civilization in the universe doing something so stupid, or maybe other civilization would be amazed. Hey, those guys find this huge prime number. That must be really advanced or completely crazy, one or the other. I think the closest star we have sent something with such powerful antenna. There is not much of those in the world. Actually, we can count them on one hand. I used to be more worried about this technical issue. You don't want to attract necessarily the attention on the Earth. Over the last 20 years, I changed my mind. And now the more and more I think we should send this message when we can still do it. I'm not sure we'll have this capacity for another few hundred years if we continue on this path.